Well, good morning, YouTubers. D-Doc here. February 9th, 2017. Had to look at the screen to see what the date was. Go figure. And in this video this morning, this is kind of a response to Rick Maylander of Classic Truck Rescue. Morning, Rick and Jamie. And all the assorted wildlife and domesticated animals he got out there on the Classic Truck Ranch. Rick Maylander of Classic Truck Rescue, one of my favorite videographers and YouTube videographers, YouTube channels. And very pleased this morning to wake up, got the time off as a bricklayer. We can't work with all this snow around. So I got the day off. I was very pleased this morning to wake up and find out Rick had posted another video. And not only had Rick of Classic Truck Rescue posted another video, but so did Jeff Bradshaw of Redneck Restoration, This Old Truck. Just had to do that. Well, Rick, gonna show you a few things. Here's one for Jamie. You know, Jamie, if y'all are watching Rick's videos, you know that Jamie, his partner, just got a job driving school buses. Well, Rick and Jamie, I live across the street from the local school, as you can see behind me. And you may hear in the background, we'll go take a look. Oh, Jamie, what do you see there? That's right, I live right next to the school bus barn. So there's a sight for you, Jamie. School buses. Yeah. All right. Well, let's get back to the task at hand. Rick had just posted a video about acquiring a 1977 Ford tow truck for one of his customers. One of his overseas customers, I think. And I wanted to show Rick a shot of my 74. Let me get behind the camera here. 1974 F-250, pretty much similar to that 77 F-350, except during one storm, tree fell down the backyard and took out a part of my grill. And I had replaced the 390 out of this engine, or out of this truck, about a year or two ago. We'll do a little walk around here, if I don't trip in the snow. I've had this truck for about 15 to 20 years. Bought it from a neighbor behind me. One of those ordeals where all my vehicles were broke down. He had this truck sitting in his backyard, so I purchased it from him. Oh, and what do we see there, Rick? An old saddle style fifth wheel trailer hitch. Incidentally, I watched your video this morning where your friend was helping you go get that 77 tow truck. And I suspect that the problems you had with your rear tire and your trailer going flat was that his trailer hitch was mounted up too high, which put too much weight on the back of your trailer, and that's probably what caused that rear tire to blow out. This truck, I don't know if we're gonna get to see this. Gonna have to do a sideways shot because I've got the camera on the tripod. We may not be able to see it, but there is a little ball hitch for the gooseneck type trailers. But I installed this fifth wheel saddle. My father used to own a 29-foot Highlander fifth wheel trailer and needed it moved. And I was the only one that had an older truck. All my brothers had newer trucks. They didn't want to punch holes in their beds to put the hitch on. So he says, Doc, bring your truck down, pick up that hitch, put it on your truck, then you can come back down and move that trailer. Well, funny story was, by the time I got down there, he just came out with the title and said, here, take this home with you. But the problem I have here, Rick, is sitting on this flatbed, the hitch is too high. So when I pulled that trailer home, it was sitting like this going down the road. Put a lot of wear or weight on the back axle, but I made it home. Anyway, I come from a family of Ford lovers. And over here we see that 97 F-150 that I commented about. I picked it up for a dirt cheap price. Let's see if we can get a backwards view of it. But it had a bad 4.6 liter engine. It's in pretty good shape. It's a little bit of rust right there on the box. A little bit of rust. Sorry for the bumps. I keep bumping into the tripod. A little bit of rust right there behind the, on the rear of the cab. And a little bit of rust there. Whoop, ran into a snowbank. A little bit of rust right here on the front of the cab, and then inside this third door on the bottom rail there's some rust, but otherwise the body of the truck was in good shape. The interior was nice and clean. A woman owned it and she kept it garaged and maintained. And as I said earlier, it just had a bad 4.6 engine. Well, I had a good 4.6 engine in this 96 Crown Victoria. It's all covered with snow. It's waiting for a good day when my junk man can come over and pick it up and take it away. And just to show you that while I do like Fords, here in the garage, I have a 95 Tahoe. Unfortunately, the transfer case went out on it. You know, I was working on this Ford truck here, put the engine in it from that Crown Victoria, and it worked very well. The only problem I had was about a week later, the rear main oil seal decided to start leaking on me. And I'm waiting for some warm weather so I can take the jack this up, drop the transmission out of it, replace the rear main oil seal, put the transmission back in it, and then this is going to be my clean truck. That's my work truck to drive to work to get dirty in. And tomorrow on Saturday, or not tomorrow, tomorrow's Friday, but on Saturday the weather's supposed to be up around 50, so I'm gonna get out here in the packed garage, jack this up, crawl underneath, take out the transfer case. My junk guy's got, he says, 5 or 6 transfer cases I can use. So we'll compare one and I'll replace the transfer case. So for right now, I'm driving my Extreme Backup 74 F-250 to get down to the next big town here where I carpool with the rest of the guys to go to work. But this truck has some issues too. Gas tank leaks at halfway, so you can only fill up half the tank. Need to replace some bushings on the front end. It's got issues, but it's driving and it's getting me to work and back. So then let's take a little bit of walk back here around the back of the house. Yeah, we got 5 inches of snow here yesterday morning. Here's that 25 foot 1969 fifth wheel Highlander that I inherited from my father. And right now it's kind of a non-rolling storage unit. And back here in the backyard is my cousin's, I believe it's a 1990 F-150 four-wheel drive, in very good shape. Only surface rust, the beginnings of surface rust on the body. And I'm storing it for him. It's got a 5.0 liter engine in it that went bad, and he's trying to find a replacement for it. And as you can see, there's one of those storage units similar to what your Tajma tent, only I don't have a tarp on it. One of these days I'll put a tarp back on it. Got assorted flatbed trailers, my motorcycle trailer, another flatbed trailer, whatnot. Well, let's go back into the front yard. Because there's a dual purpose here, besides showing off my 74 F250 for Rick Maylander. It's only about 15 degrees out here this morning in western central Iowa, about 2 miles east of the Missouri River. So the next project I'm doing for today, see if I can find my way in here without too much trouble. While I'm out here today, I'm gonna do 3 cold starts. Whoops. Gonna do some finagling. Well, we're gonna start, hey there, with the 95 Tahoe. The door don't knock the camera over, which it wants to. And as I said earlier, it's 15 degrees out here, Rick. It's cold. But it's been a while since I started this vehicle up. Let's give it a shot. Take my old transfer case out, pull it out, throw it in the back of the F-250, take it over to my junk man, and maybe he can match me up and find me another transfer case put back into this so I could drive this to work. Be a little more reliable than the F-250, but, you know. Let's find our way out of this garage. It's pretty jam-packed in here. And we're going to move right over to the 97, find solid ground here, the 97 F-150. See if we can get the camera a little adjusted here. And we'll do a cold start of the 97 F-150. It's a runner. As I mentioned, I got this truck dirt cheap. The inherent problem was the motor was bad, and I replaced the motor, as I stated earlier. And once I got it running, I found out that the rear axle was whining. And so I went and bought a replacement rear axle and put that on. That took care of the whine, so that was the rear pinion gear probably was going out of whack. But it's going to be a nice driver as soon as I get that rear main oil seal leaked on another warm day. First it's Tahoe to get fixed, then it's going to be this 97 F-150 that's going to get fixed. But on a warmer days, Rick, you know what I mean. So let's go on over to the F-250. and we'll do a cold start of this. Now this one's got a 390, Rick, and I replaced it too. Those 390s are getting hard to find, especially the older ones. If you buy a later model 390, it was such a popular engine that the casting mold wore out, and the casting was very thin back by the rear main seal. So the later model 390s had a tendency to leak out of the rear main seal. So finding a replacement older 390 is kind of tough. The older ones had a tendency not to leak, but I was lucky. My junk guy, there's a body shop guy working for him, and he had an old 390 out of he thinks it was a 69 or a 70 Galaxy that he had taken out, purred like a kitten, somewhere between 55,000 and 75,000 miles on the motor. And then he set that engine underneath his counter in his shed for about 20 years, then sold it to me. And sure enough, it started right up, purrs like a kitten. Now you'll hear some exhaust leak because I had to adapt the exhaust to fit. But let's get busy on the cold start here. Let's see if we can get you in the picture. Maybe move the camera over a little and adjust it some more. This has been a good old truck for me, Rick. It's got some issues, but it does start and run. And kind of like a tinker truck, got to tinker with it to get it running. But let's quit hesitating and get around to a cold start on this one. Well, there we have it. A triple cold start for my fans out here on my YouTube channel, DDoc Spec. And a little bit of videoing for Rick Maylander over at Classic Truck Rescue. You know, Rick, I guess we all like to dinker with things. Like I said, I'm pretty much particular with the Fords, but I am driving a Chevy. Anyway, that's gonna about wrap it up for today, because it's only about 15 degrees over here in western central Iowa, about 2 miles east of the Missouri River. And I'm going to go back inside and get warmed up and spend the rest of my day inside a warm house. And I'll upload this video. Thanks for watching, all my viewers. Rick and Jamie, good year to you. Thank you for your videos. And we'll catch you all on the next video.